Okay, so I do admit that once in a while we can get a bit stalkerish, right? You know, when you're sitting here on the computer and you have absolutely nothing to do, what's more fun than to lurk somebody, right? So I'm looking up Kiki Kannibal, and you know, she's probably like, wow, she's all over the motherfucking internet. I don't really have an opinion on her because I've never talked to her. I've seen her one time at Warped Tour, but that was like for a second. I was like, oh my god, Kiki Kannibal. It was just funny. But from what I've seen and what I've read from her, there's so many different opinions about her. It's like, oh my god. There's this journal on BuzzNet, and it was from a girl that bought one of Kiki's jewelry. And she goes on to say that Kiki said that she would look great in her jewelry, you should buy it. So this girl's like, alright. She says that she spent over $200 on two necklaces. Let me just enlighten you on this. And if this is real and if this is true, my opinions on Kiki have changed dramatically because what a bitch. Alright, are you ready? The girl says that when she opened the package, it was all broken. No offense, I don't think you packed it very well. The diamond was split down the middle and cracked at the sides. I can send you a photo if you don't believe me. Kiki says, Jackie, my jewelry is made from high quality... I don't know what that says. If it was damaged in the past, it is not my fault, but the postal service is. You said you wanted normal instead of UPS. I gave you the choice to opt for a safer service, so I cannot be held responsible. Please take that journal down, Kiki. Which is a good response, okay? She says... The girl says, but UPS would cost me another $50, and I couldn't afford it after spending $210. It wasn't just one piece that was broken, the whole lot was smashed. It was just in a box with a lot of tissue that smelled like perfume. They weren't separated, and all the crystals had fallen off. I've told my mom because it was her PayPal, and she said you didn't pack it properly, and I should be able to get at least a PayPal refund. She has emailed PayPal asking them what to do. And Kiki all of a sudden just goes, warning, if you do not close the PayPal claim, I will take legal action against you as I am losing business. You will pay for my losses. And you're just like, what? Like, okay, the girl says, then can I please have a refund? It's really unfair, and I know I'm not the only person who has had a problem with your jewelry and lost money. I thought we were friends, but you just took advantage of me for my money. The only thing Kiki says is take that journal down. This is liable. I can get you arrested for spreading defamatory information. What? That doesn't even answer any of her questions about, like, a refund or anything. The girl goes, you treated me really nicely, and the second I bought your jewelry, you ignored me. It's the truth. I thought we were friends. Kiki goes, I was never your friend. Stop saying that. You were nothing but a fan, but now you're turning into an obsessed, jealous hater, just like everyone else. Go do some exercise instead of writing hate journals about me. What? Like, are you serious? Like, this poor fucking girl bought your jewelry, and she's being like really nice. Like, I'm gonna tell you right now, if this was me, and if I spent fucking $210 on some fucking piece of plastic, and it came to me broken, and I told Kiki that it was broken, and she told me that I was turning into an obsessed, jealous fan hater, I don't, whatever, I would beat the shit out of her. Okay, the last two things, the girl says, you're so rude. You actually made me feel good about myself for one day this month. You kept on telling me how pretty I look with your jewelry on. That's what friends do. Everything anyone said about you is right. You're just nice to people so you can take their money. And Kiki said, if you were truly worried about your weight, you would go out and do some exercise instead of obsessing over me. You've turned into another obsessed, jealous, fat... stalker. I've seen it before. You're one step away from putting stripes in your hair. Now leave me alone. You're older than me and you know better than to be picking on me like this. No, I'm not even kidding. Can you just, like, take a look at this for a second? Okay. I don't know if you can even read it. You can't even read it, but if you want to see the thing, just fucking message me. I will send you the link to it because I think that this is complete bullshit. Because if this is the truth, and I have done my research on this fucking girl, okay? Don't get me wrong. I've heard a lot of things about how her jewelry, like, people have gotten it and it has been good or whatever, but the thing is that I've never actually seen a picture of anybody with, like, fucking Kiki Kannibal jewelry. I mean, you can't even tell the difference. It's the same thing as any other fucking seen kid wearing a fucking diamond jewelry thing going on here, you know? And it's like, what? Like, I don't know. I've heard a lot of stuff about her, how, like... Like, why? I'm sorry, but I just don't understand why, how she would handle that way. Like, seriously, sometimes if you watch her on Sitcam Live, like, sometimes she's funny, sometimes she's entertaining, but most of the time you're just, like, losing IQ points by the minute. Like, seriously, you're just like, what is this girl on? Like, that's all I could think about, really, honestly, when I watch her live. I'm just like, I need your drugs. But, I mean, you can't always believe everything that you read about someone, because, of course, if you hate someone, you're gonna probably make it seem like that person is a lot more worse than they really are, which is why I'm not taking a stand on whether I hate or love Kiki. I mean, as of right now, I don't even fucking know this girl. Never had a conversation with her in my life, except for one time when Lexi and I called her live on her save cam and she hung up on us. Oh yeah, and when she used to have a MySpace, when I first became her friend, of course, I told her that she needed to get a tan in one of her pictures, and she blocked me. Apparently she blocks everyone if they say just the littlest thing to her. Block. Her is her fucking nude photos. How she got banned off MySpace is because she posted a naked picture of herself because her ex-boyfriend posted it. So she was like, ugh, I'm going to put it on MySpace because I don't care. Who does that? Okay, seriously, first of all, you will never see me have a nude picture, ever. I promise you that. Especially of the fact that I'm kind of internet popular. I mean, I know I'm not as internet popular as Kiki Kannibal because she is such a controversy to the world. Like, there's like 50% haters, 50% lovers, and I'm just kind of in the middle right now. But, yeah, I actually found another nude picture of her just like looking for information, and I'm like, oh my god, like that's like embarrassing. Like, that's why I have a moral that I will never take nude pictures. Especially, why would she even do that, especially since she knows she's so popular on the internet? I mean, does she like not think that it's gonna get around, unless she just really doesn't care, which bothers me about her. I mean, I'd love to have a fucking conversation with her, but to me it just seems like she's screw me over or block me or something. I don't even know. But apparently there's this whole thing about seeing queens on BuzzNet, and I'm just like now learning about it. But I mean, like, of course I always knew who Audrey Kitchen, I don't even know if I'm saying her name right, quite frankly, I don't even care. But okay, she's a gorgeous girl. She's in my Who I Like to Meet, the pink haired lady, you know. But I've heard a lot of shit about her, but once again, you can always like believe what you read. But I mean, like, I don't even know, like, how did this all begin? Like, okay, this girl named Hannah Beth, she has a picture wearing a Fuck Kiki Kannibal t-shirt, okay? And here she is right here with her little Fuck Kiki Kannibal t-shirt. And I read something about the guy next door saying that he had the shirt and Hannah Beth just wanted to take a picture. I know, I'm sounding like a complete lurker right now, but I mean, come on. Don't judge, okay? I just have a lot of time on my hands. And I like to research Kiki Kannibal because I am an obsessed stalker hater. Okay, no. Anyways, I'm just trying to find out the facts and get some information about her so that I can actually base an opinion about her, which I don't really know. I mean, there's so much controversy on this subject. Kiki Kannibal is like, I think she takes really good pictures. She's a gorgeous girl. Kiki Kannibal is gorgeous. I don't give a fuck what anyone says about that. But she takes really nice pictures. But the things that I've read about her just have not been optimistic. I mean, there's that once in a while, like, ooh, I love Kiki, but I mean, you know, those just internet people. I get that all the time. It's like, do you really love me? Like, what is your reasoning behind that? That's why when I see someone on the internet, like Kiki Kannibal, like internet famous, I'm not gonna go ahead and be like, oh my god, I love you, you're so pretty, make you such good pictures. I need some information, you know. I need to research and stuff like that to get an opinion about someone. And from what I've seen about Kiki Kannibal, it's just like, I don't know. I don't know. I'm never gonna buy her jewelry, that's one thing for sure. And I feel extraordinarily bad for that girl who got jacked out of $200. And I've also read another journal on here. There's a lot of fucking shit about Kiki Kannibal on BuzzNet.com if you have not checked that out. I just got one the other day, so look me up. But yeah, I feel really bad for those people that got scammed, and if I ever saw Kiki Kannibal in person again, I probably would punch her. I'm sorry, she deserves a good fucking ass whooping. And from when I saw her at Warped Tour, she was a stick. And, I could take her good. So, out of K. That's just my rant about Kiki Kannibal. All these fucking MySpace queens. My god. I don't think I'm a MySpace queen.